For this workshop, I will present you a forging sequence that has been simulated with Forge. This is the production of the engine valves. So manufacturing processes are becoming more and more complex and require a perfect control of parameter to achieve and to obtain a high performance product. So the aim of this presentation is to demonstrate that Forge is an essential tool to master all stages of your manufacturing processes. And especially for this example, the engine valves that equip the engine of our vehicles. So we will focus on three main stages of the manufacturing process. So there is three forming operations: the friction welding, the electrical upsetting, and the hot forging step. So before beginning the presentation and the detail of the simulation, I will give you some information about the product, about the engine valves. What are they used for and in which environment do they operate? So the engine valve equipped our combustion engine. So we have generally two or four valves in the engine for each combustion chamber, depend on the engine specification and so on. So it exists two sorts. The first one is the inlet, which is used to administrate a mix of air and fuel inside the combustion chamber. Then the piston moves up to compress the gas. We initiate a spark, it generates one explosion, and it moves down the piston. And then it makes the crankshaft rotate and so on. So when the piston moves up, we open the exhaust valve to exit the exhaust gases. So you can see on this animation that the part must undergo extreme environment. You can have some high temperature up to 1000 degrees. You have the explosion, so you have a high pressure and impact stress, and they are also subject to corrosion due to this mixture. So depending on the engine, they are made of different materials. It can be stainless steel, titanium in Cornell, and they can be mono or bimetallic valves. So for our study, we have selected a bimetallic valve. So the valve is composed of one material at the head. This is 21-4N austenitic stainless steel to get high performances for heat and impact forces. And for the steam, we have the EN52 martensite steels, which is known to get high tensile stress. And to get an idea about the dimension, the parts are the length of under and 10 millimeter. And for both diameter, we have 30 millimeter and 6 millimeter for the rod. So the engine valve undergo a large number of forging operation and heat treatment operation to guarantee their mechanical properties. So the manufacturing process can be divided into three forming operations. So the first one is the friction welding. So you have two parts made of two different steel and they are joined together by friction. Then you have the electrical upsetting. The aim of this operation is to obtain a pre-shape, and this pre-shape is then forged on a screw press to get the final shape of the valve. So after this forming operation, you generally have several heat treatments and finishing steps. So you can have some induction heating and quench to get a bit hard, a bigger hardness here. And you have generally some polishing operation to improve the flow of the air during the administration and the exhaust. So for this study, we will focus on these three main operations. So here is how looks like the project in Forge. So you have five main operations. The first one is a welding operation with two different parts. Then you have the electrical upsetting. You have one deformable part, one deformable die, and the multi-material feature. We will see it in detail. And at the end, you have the hot forging step. You have some intermediate cooling for the transfer time between each step. So as you can see, some steps are linked together. They are chained, which means that you are you transfer automatically the result from the first one. But since the last version of Forge 3.0, you can unchain some stages. So typically here, we have some transition where we have applied a manual operation before going further. So for example, when you are doing the friction welding, you have excess of material that need to be cut before doing the electrical upsetting. So as you can see, we use many functionalities of our software, the thermomechanical and electrical solver, the multi-material feature, multi-body, deformable dies, and so on. So the first operation is the direct die friction welding. So how does it work? This is a welding operation without material deposits. So one of the parts rotates at a controlled speed, and the other one moves and applies a force on the first one. The friction hits materials, and the pressure applies, joins the part together. So in a short time, in a real short time, the temperature increases from room temperature to 1,600 degrees. So you can see three main operations. The first one is the initialization of the rotation and the clamping. Then you have the welding and you forge the part. So the numerical modeling of the first step has been done with two axisymmetric geometries. So you have two separate meshes for both material, the head and the stem. So which means that we have two material files. So we have selected two GMAT Pro material files to cover the large scale of temperature. The first one is rotating. So we need to load the special torsion friction model, defined at the interface between the rotational die and the parts, in which you can define the rotation speed according to the time. And on the other side, you will apply a force with an interface set. So for the results, you have the illustration of the temperature evolution and the friction welding. So you can see the three different steps, the initial contact rotation, then welding and forging. So in the welding zone, we reach a temperature of 1,600 degrees. It's relatively easy to test other conditions. In this example, we have set a given rotation per minute. So it's easy to make a copy of your setup, of your step, and to change the parameters to see the influence of another velocity on this area. Also for the clamping force. So after the simulation, you can also analyze other results, such as the rotational speed or the number of turns of the part. So for this first operation, it took 35 minutes on one course. Then second operation is the electrical upsetting. So the electrical upsetting enables to deform the material by applying electric current through conduction. So the workpiece is held against the anvil here and clamped between two part jaws. And you have here a high density electricity current. It flows between the jaws and the anvil plate and it hits the exposed portion. And then the desired shape of the preform is upset via the axially applied pressure. So here you can see the anvil, two part jaws. And you can imagine that you have the bottom anvil here, which is moving up to give the shape of the preform. So to do this kind of simulation, we made some improvement in our solver 2 years ago. So basically how it works, so we need three main blocks to describe all phenomena which are on this kind of simulation. So we have three main blocks, the electricity, heat transfer, and mechanics. So at the beginning, from this equation, we compute the current and potential density, then it computes the joule heating power, and of course it will drive the heating, the temperature evolution inside the pot. So the material property are directly linked to the temperature, so we need to make like a loop to take into account the elevation of the temperature for the resistivity, for example. And we need also to take into account the deformation, which comes from the forming operation. That's why we also need this block of the solver. So we have an electro-thermomechanical solver. So these three blocks has been quite new in Forge for this field. So for the numerical modeling, we still use 2D axis symmetry. So for we have two deformable parts, the billet and here the jaw. For the billet, we have imported the result from the first operation, and we made some manual operation to remove the excess of material, the blur, and to merge two meshes. And then you have three rigid parts to define the boundary condition, the anvil and the side jaw holder. So now the part is designed with only one mesh, so you need to define the second material with the multi-material feature. So by default, you have one material everywhere, and then in here, you will import the shape of the first set from the first simulation to define the second materials here. So you can easily load a mesh to get the right shape of this part. And for the mesh, we generally refine the mesh in this zone where we have high strain, and also near to the contact between the jaws and the billet to get the perfect current density calculation. So the multi-material mesh will be automatically done when you mesh your part. For the electrical settings, the current input is defined on the side jaw holder here, so with an intensity of average 1100 ampere. And you need to define the zero potential on the anvil here. And you will force the current to flow from this direction to this direction. Concerning the kinematic, the bottom anvil push the rod against the top anvil with a constant speed, which can be done with an hydraulic press in Forge. And the top anvil moves also with the bottom anvil to control the shape of the preform. So you need, you can define here a high versus time press to make the link with the other press. So here you have the animation of the electrical upsetting process, and you have the temperature evolution. You can also analyze other results, like the effective strain or the current density, also the electrical potential and electrical field. And it's quite difficult to obtain the right shape because it depends on all parameter you set on your setup. I mean, we have seen the current, the force, and the movement of both anvil. So this shape has been obtained for a couple of parameters. So it's really easy to study the influence of this parameter by doing other copy and starting other simulation to see their impact on the shape of the preform. And the shape of the preform is very essential to guarantee the good, the last forging operation. So this computation took around 1 hour on one course. And the last one is the hot forging operation. So the preform here must be forged to get the final shape. So a manipulator took the part from the electrical upsetting and put it into the dies. And thanks to a screw press, we forge and we obtain the desired shape of the engine, of the valve. So here's some illustration of the temperature evolution and the material flow. Other illustration about the effective strain on the head, the forging load, and the grain flow prediction. In the post-treatment, you can also analyze where are both materials with material sets, material analysis. You can also display the contact to see eventual underfilling. So this is a flashless operation. There is no flash at the end. And if you want to go further, there is some tools in Forge to analyze the dies, for example, the abrasion wear. You can also analyze the tensile and compressive stress into the dies, the deflection, or you can do some thermal steady state calculation to see the temperature of your dies after a number of parts. So to conclude, I want to say that Forge is a complete solution to simulate the entire process. We have seen that we can simulate all steps from the friction welding to the hot forging step. You have also heat treatment possibilities with the induction and quench. You have dedicated templates for a large range of simulation, which guarantee an easy workflow. You can also customize all your data into the store manager. We have different solver and functionalities to be able to simulate this complex process, like the electrical solver, multi-material, multi-body. And there is a lot of benefits because for this process, we can analyze many results. We can make a detailed study of the entire process. You can estimate and reduce the cycle times and cost optimization, of course. And if you want to make another product or to change a scale and so on, you can do easily some feasibility studies by changing parameters and so on. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Max, for this very impressive presentation.